streets of Detroit, Michigan. Your ass is listening to Radio Underground. All right, Radio Underground, and we're here with an old school contributor. And by old school, I mean really old school, back in the FM days, and then 2019 when we started the podcast.
Radio Underground.
Yeah.
The Kojak. Original.
One of the OGs, Kojak. How's shit been, man?
It's good, man. You know, I'm getting old. Yeah. My hair is getting gray.
Yeah. Well, fuck, look at me. I look like a wizard at this point.
I'm totally lying. I have no
grand wizard.
I have no gray hair yet. I don't know why.
No.
I'm defying time somehow.
You're like... Well, the thing is, you lost your hair when we were young, but you never, like... Nothing about your hair, like, got worse after that. You didn't get no gray, nothing.
No, it stayed bald.
Stayed bald. You got a good complexion. Nothing really bad happened after that, do you?
No, even my beard has stayed whatever the hell this is. Blonde, I think.
Yeah.
Dirty blonde. I don't know.
Something the fucking Celt saw when they came across the North Sea and killed them. Whatever you did. So anyway, we decided to do this impromptu podcast because we talked about the uptick in alien stuff with the government, and you see it on Twitter, you see it everywhere. There's something going on with the alien thing.
Something's going on. Be it true, be it not true.
Yeah.
But yeah, we started out just bullshitting over some beers. I'm like, you know what? Let's fucking put this on audio.
Yeah, because we're never going to get just like the two of us. And it's hard to, when you want to talk about one thing, it's hard because radio, all our bros, everybody that's ever contributed, everybody's great, but we all have, we got to get our shit in and get out. So you can't really deep dive into much. And so we're going to just get into this. Alien conspiracy, whatever it may be.
Yeah, whatever.
I don't know.
The funny part is we will do this over a couple of beers for funsies. You know, we like to throw around theories and kick them out a little bit and have a good time with it and find out how deep we can go just for funs. And you had the idea. I was like, you know what? Let's get an audio on this.
Yeah.
Why don't we just record this tonight? We record our stupid conspiracy theories, and some of them aren't conspiracy theories. Some of them are proven fact now. Clearly, aliens are proven fact.
Yeah.
We have the evidence.
Yeah, you can't deny it. You're a flat earther at this point.
Yeah, I mean, come on.
They got it. They got the proof.
That dude in Nevada where the alien landed in his backyard, I mean, that's proof.
Yeah.
It's proof.
What more do you need?
He caught Bigfoot on video, but, you know, he met the aliens.
So, essentially what we're talking about, there's an uptick in the government... releasing things, and then on Twitter you see different videos, different pictures, different, you know, document releases and stuff, and it kind of
it's a hot button.
It's a topic right now, and we got to strike while the oven's hot here.
Yeah, we've been doing this for at least 80 years together.
Yeah, but this is just a preview of what has happened many Saturdays for, I don't know, 20 plus years. Just never recorded it.
We truly like to drink ourselves into a conspiracy mindset.
Yeah.
And then find the worst one possible and make it real.
Yeah. See, the thing is, like, the whole point is debunking a conspiracy theory. Our thing is, we do it backwards. We're going to make it true. We're going to prove it true. Even if we don't believe it, the point is to make it seem true.
Yeah. We've always had a lot of fun with this, too, because I will... I wouldn't say go off the deep end, but I will grab the hardest conspiracy theory or whatever. I mean, if you believe it's a conspiracy theory, I fucking clearly don't.
Yeah.
But you find that, and then you'll be like, okay, well, why is this? Why is that? And, you know, I like this and I like that. But and I'll be like, no, Mike, David Icke was right.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think lizard people is your thing, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
I hate lizard people. I can't stand a lizard people thing.
Lizardry is real. They run the entire world.
Shut up.
Yeah. But you're more of a... Lost civilizations guy. This is different.
I love history, right? Like, you know, in my younger years, as we all get older and smarter, you change your opinions. If you didn't, you'd be an idiot.
Yeah.
So I started out with, civilizations was founded by aliens, you know, Anunnaki and all that shit, because you buy into it when you're
chariots of fire.
Yeah. you buy into it when you're 20 years old, right? Like, oh, Pod's going to save the world, man.
Yeah.
You know, you buy into that shit.
Yeah.
And you get older, and you're like, well.
It doesn't?
maybe 12-year-olds shouldn't be smoking pot, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, so we're doing a...
If you do too much pot, you're going to be on a plane saying, that motherfucker isn't real.
Yeah.
You're going to be that chick.
The two buddies you know that can smoke pot since they were 15 and never affected them, Joe Rogan and our personal friend. There are a few of them people that exist, right?
Yeah.
You're not that person. We're not that person.
It's going to affect you eventually.
I'm not that person. I haven't smoked pot in 20 years because when I smoke it, I'm going to bed.
Yeah.
I'm going to bed because I can't handle it.
No.
Because the aliens.
Yeah.
I see.
I've always said I'm paranoid and hungry enough. I don't need any help in that regard.
And speaking of that, if you like me personally, right? The paranoia part, I can't do that anymore. If I smoke pot, I get paranoid of nothing. I just want to be like, leave me alone, everybody. For no reason. We were here
get away from me.
Oh, we'll start out with a fun story, right? We started certain neighbors. You know, they did the dabs, you know, they were into the dabs.
Yeah,
I
remember those guys.
Dabs was new. I was a smoker back, you know, in my early days.
During the chronic.
So, you know, I never did a dab, and they were trying to get me to smoke it forever. I'm like, I'm not going to smoke it. I'm not going to smoke it. You know, I'm just not going to do dabs. I don't smoke that shit. I hate it. So one night I said, okay, fuck it. There's three of them here. They're all doing dabs. I'm like, Frank, just try it. He says, okay, I'll try it one time. All three of them got super excited and started pouring all their dabs, their personal stash, into the whatever they call it. It's a bomb.
See how it do you.
Yeah.
The old white guy. These are Mexican kids, by the way.
Yes, yes. And I got them by at least 15 years. So I says, okay, I'll hit it. So I hit this thing. I went right to Mars.
Yeah.
Right to Mars. I had a whole adventure.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And when I came back, I looked up at these guys like, everybody's got to go home. Yeah. Now, at first, they were like, what do you mean? Then I said, you guys got to go home. Leave now. I am somewhere else, and I'm not with you right now.
Yeah.
They laughed, but they left.
You saw the lizards.
I did. I got bit.
Lizardry. It was there.
It was lizardry. So I didn't handle that experience well.
No.
But, yeah. Anyways.
So the like, basically, now over the years, mine and your opinions on all this has changed.
Evolved.
It's evolved, yes. Like, my thing is, I was all about aliens and thought it was 100% true until the government started admitting to it. And I'm such an anti-government right-winger that I'm like, okay, it's a lie.
Yeah,
because the government's saying it's real, it's a lie.
I was hoping you'd let me say it.
Yeah.
You're so anti-government that if they say it, you're like, right away, nope, not true.
Yeah. Okay, now I know it's fake. If the government wants me to believe in aliens, they got to continue to deny it.
even though we all know that it's like a 50-year plan to slowly let us in, you know, make it a thing. Because look at today's world, right? You say, hey, man, I think they found a plant with water and aliens on it. Most average person would be like, yeah, so.
You know, that's true.
Yeah, I'm going to look at my TikTok. Look at this girl shaking her butt. I'm going to look.
I think there's high-ranking like public officials have said, basically, there's aliens. Like, not just some guy that used to work for. You remember when in the 90s?
Bob
guys,
Lazar.
Yeah, it was Lazar.
Lazar blew it wide open.
Yeah, and then it was people like that, or like the guys that were in England and they followed that ball of light around.
Yeah,
the
and then one guy touched the craft and he seen the hieroglyphs and he wrote a code out. Right.
That's basically all you had. But now you got like people that like Biden, not Biden, but like people like high ranking up, like
probably not Biden.
But he's seeing some aliens right now.
He didn't see any. When he has never said anything coherent ever.
Yeah, when he's shitting his pants, he's seeing aliens. But there's enough. I guess I am doing the air quotes. Credible people that are saying, yeah, this is the thing.
So the average person like you,
yeah,
average as hell, will say. Things like, well,
100 IQ, 5'10", everything about me is normal.
Well,
I'm a midwit.
A midwit. A lot of people will follow that. They'll toll that line, right? Look at all these credible people. Look at all these credible people coming out saying this, saying that. We have the videos.
I did the air quotes out, by the way.
I'm doing the hand chops.
Okay, yeah. All right.
like a stern dad. I'm doing the hand.
We're towing the line.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's a very common thing to say. Most people will say that. Well, look at all these credible people coming out, this and that.
Your brother. I need a credible source of this bullshit.
But in reality, it's never stopped being said. You can go back thousands of years with stories of that. It's just never stopped, right?
Yeah.
A lot of our ancestors clearly attribute it to gods, demons. I mean, some people, you can even argue that religion is based on that stuff.
Yeah.
Because of the cargo.
Well, God came from the sky, right?
Yeah.
It makes sense.
This ain't arguing the fact that there's a God or not a God.
No, my only thing is, like, I've told you this before we started recording. I don't know what I believe, but I know this. The if there's anything that I possibly believe, we are seated here, and that's where the God thing comes from. God comes from the sky. Everything's the sky. How and what, I don't know. So, I haven't read as many books as you. I don't fucking read.
Well, the
I'm anti-reading across the board.
Well, I've wrapped myself in ancient history and this shit for a long time, right? You know, and your opinion changes because society changes. They get smarter. They learn more. You learn more, you know.
Yeah.
When I started out, it was, oh, this is an interesting thing, right? Sounds cool. I like it. You know, it piques my imagination, so I'm going to dive into it, and it turns out to be great, right? With your imagination and what you can come up with.
Chariots of fire.
Chariots of the gods.
Oh, those gods. I'm sorry. Yeah, not fire. That's a movie. I'm getting the movie mixed up with the fucking book.
No, the very day Graham Hancock did anything, you know, I was the number one fan.
Yeah.
Right away. I've been following that dude since I can remember. But he changed his opinion too, as most do, right? With time and you learn more and whatever.
Well, that's called the scientific process. New information comes in. Oh, wait, I was wrong.
Yeah.
Not like, hey, this is how it is forever.
Right?
Yeah.
But as you were saying, most people will go, I mean, the average consensus is, okay, this is getting serious. Governments are putting out videos. It's starting to gain some steam. You know, credible people are coming out and saying things, and they are. And it is happening nonetheless, as we all have seen. Tom DeLong, he started all that, which,
yeah,
you know, credit to him from my point of view, because if I had his money or his whatever it is, I'd be doing the same damn thing. If I won that $1 billion jackpot the other day,
yeah,
you better believe I'd start some damn organization.
Yeah,
try to do that, because really, that's what I care about. You know, everything else is just fun time, but that's the interesting stuff.
Yeah,
you know, I'd get a hold of Elon Musk, build a rocket, fly out to space, and look at all the fucking aliens on the dark side of the moon.
Yeah,
but yeah, no, the consensus is, look at all these people coming out and saying this.
Yes.
When the fact of the matter is, it's been being said forever. People just thought they were kooks, or, you know, it didn't make any sense, this and that. Roswell, you know, started in 47.
Well, basically, every religion, every ancient text, every hieroglyph cave painting points towards something from the sky, right? That's how it all is.
You could put it that way, or you could put it this way. The entire human history of everywhere has said consistently across the globe the same basic story, right?
Yeah, there's a flood, right? That one?
Yeah, the Epic of Gilgamesh. I don't care who the fuck says it, whatever. Yeah. Epic of Gilgamesh is the first, right? Ancient Sumerian, whatever, you know, the very first text of it. Some people called it Noah afterwards, but...
Yeah.
I mean, that was Constantine started Christianity in which goes zero, right? The year zero, Jesus and all that. The only reason Christianity took off...
Celsius.
some things people don't know is that religion was not allowed to be practiced by poor people. You know, that was not a thing. You were not allowed to publicly practice religion as an average human. It was only the rich and powerful.
Okay.
Constantine was the first.
I like that.
Constantine was the first emperor, whatever, to institute Christianity. And he said it's why everybody can do it. And the only way he can get the people to accept it was he took stories that they were familiar with. In, for lack of a better term, their paganism, right? Their Epic of Gilgamesh, you know. All the stories they had in religion, he fit neatly and compacted it very neatly into something we call Christianity. That is the only way those people were going to accept that religion. And it took off, right? Because now poor people can do it. They can practice still their paganism without being persecuted. But now they got to call it Christianity is all they had to do.
Yeah.
And they did. You know, and it took off. Moreover, that's just a certain part of the world. We're not talking about the other part, which would let's consider India or China, right? India.
Yeah.
The Vedic texts.
The Far East.
The Vedic texts go back even further, and they talk about vehicles in the sky, you know, not Enki, but it was written. We didn't even know that part existed in the Bible.
Yeah.
I can't think of his name. It wasn't Enki.
I don't know.
Ezekiel.
Ezekiel, okay.
Ezekiel. So that part of the Bible was taken out.
A wheel in the sky, right?
The Council of Nicaea took it out in the 1200s or so. But when we discovered the Dead Sea Scrolls in the 50s, I think it was.
Yeah.
50s or 30s and whatever. Then we discovered the book of Ezekiel and all that. And then we had a whole bunch of others. The very first Christians, if you guys didn't know, the very first sect of Christians wrote the Dead Sea Scrolls. And they had all the books of the Bible in there. And that's when we discovered these lost books that were taken out 600-700 years ago. Fun part about that one book, Ezekiel, it literally just says that these weird saucer shapes came down and took him up into space and let him look at the earth from up there. I mean, this guy was telling the shit in his book.
Jesus?
No. Ezekiel.
Or Ezekiel, okay.
The book of Ezekiel. That's why it was taken out then. Because really what it says is, hey, these people came down, took me up in the sky, and I could look down on Earth. I could see the Earth from space, basically. He didn't know how to explain it. He was just trying to approximate,
yeah.
Yeah, and that book was snatched out, you know, years ago. Lots of books were, we found, whatever. And there's something to be said for those books, or the, what am I looking for here? It was very strange how he wrote things. A silver disc. I mean, even Alexander the Great in his stories says that he had two silver shields flying over him when he was attacking a certain city. I don't remember the name of the city. Forgive me. I'm not a hardcore archaeologist.
Some city that was getting sacked.
Yeah.
Badly.
But he was having shields in the air follow him, kind of like record history. That's how he kind of put it. That's how we would say it today, right?
Yeah.
We understand what was happening. They're recording what he was doing. But bottom line is, these stories have been since the beginning of time. It's not just credible Air Force pilots today.
Yeah.
Right? Now it's a hot button topic. Things are coming out because we're probably, what, since Roswell, we're at, like, what, 70 years now?
Yeah, the modern alien conspiracy.
Even the mindset, right? The whole point of the conversation we're talking about right now is the mindset. Now you can say it, and most people are like, yeah, whatever.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, the mindset's where it is. You're at the ilk where, yeah, the government says it. COVID was their first bullshit. We're getting judgment day.
Yeah, I was talking about my theory was the... Okay, so they didn't want, there was a certain election result they wanted to not happen. So they're like, okay, here we're going to release this COVID here. Okay, that worked at that time. Now, how do we up it? How do we take it up a notch? Alien invasion. So now they're going to do the Project Blue Beam, which never really happened, but it's something they've been working on.
It's a classic conspiracy theory, right? If you know anything about it, if some of you are hearing it for the first time, you'll probably go look it up. But Operation Blue Beam is basically a fake alien invasion to gain more control, right? And as you
unify the people, and yeah, we'll all get behind one banner because aliens are coming.
Yeah, hypersonic drones, and then holograms.
And then you put the chip in your arm and fucking get the food. That's basically the idea.
And you're going to tattoo a 666 barcode on the back of your neck. Yeah. But, I mean, that's ultimately what you could say, right? Now that the aliens are dumping out, okay, your side of view hasn't changed much.
No.
It is, okay, government says it, fuck it, we're all going to die. Government's doing it. We do have credible reports. Like the problem is they're not new.
It's always
all that's just been there. But now, as we all know, we have a ton of access to cameras, videos, and all that. And most people say, "Well, where's the evidence?" You know, say if you're a non-believer at all, they say if you don't believe in aliens whatsoever and can't happen, first thing you're going to say is, "Where's the evidence?" Well, I'd say to you, you're not looking. You know, you're avoiding looking because it's all over the place. Number one, it's all through history. You can find that all over the place.
It's like asking somebody that grew up in a large city, like, where's the evidence of drafts? Like, if there wasn't video, well, there's none here. Where's the drafts? I don't see a draft around here.
The problem with evidence is you choose to believe it or don't believe it, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you can go back to the paintings. You know, we've all seen the paintings throughout.
Yeah, of craft, of alien craft.
Yeah, I mean, somebody goes, oh, that's just bullshit. One simple question. Okay, what is it? Why is it? It's not one painting. There's tons of paintings. Hell, there's cave paintings that show it.
Of people in them, aliens in them.
Yeah.
Different creature. Yeah.
Indigenous North American Indians have stories of Skywatchers, right? They have stories of them. They have, you break it down, it's an exact sentence is, hey, if you were to put it in today's speech,
yeah,
alien came down, talked to us, told us to be good, they're watching us, and left. That would be a very simple way to put it today.
Yeah.
We would understand it, yeah. Right?
Cliff Notes version.
Yeah, the Cliff Notes version. But the fact still remains, it's there. It's always been there, right? The indigenous people of America who have no outside influence, have no connection to anything, right? Until we came here and...
Yeah.
And flewed them to death.
Yeah.
But they still have the same stories. So where do those stories come from? Did they make them up? Yes, they made them up. Okay, fine. Fair enough. They made them up. So why does every other culture on the planet have this story? I mean, what's China's, even China, their creation story? Like their story where their whole civilization came from is a woman came down on a silver disc, landed, got out, and gave them civilization. Like what?
Yeah, a disc. Silver disc.
A silver ship came from the sky. They called it a dragon at that point.
Yeah.
You know, they have their names for it. It's obviously lack of a better term for them. But, I mean, China's oldest creation story is somebody coming down from the sky in a silver disc and giving them civilization.
Well, that was my point earlier. Everything comes from the sky. No matter the religion or the people or the race or whatever, it's always something from the sky.
Yeah. And then, you could literally segue that into every civilization on the planet has a story.
Yeah.
Namely, a flood story.
Right? Yeah.
The flood story is the oldest constant story. You can't find a more solid story in civilizations across the planet than the flood story, right? Everybody has it. Everyone has it, which is fine in itself, right?
Yeah.
Here's the key to it. What they also say, which people often don't talk about, is that right after that, these other people showed up and brought them civilization, right? Brought them how to read stars, math, science, like everything. And they all say the same thing. This isn't isolated. There's a flood story, and then people showed up. And then pyramids are built across the entire planet. Like every single continent.
Yeah, they're everywhere.
Yeah, every continent has a pyramid.
In Scotland, I saw a pretty cool, badass one in Scotland Scotland has pyramids? What the fuck?
America, you know, North America has pyramids.
South America.
South America is loaded with them. China has them. What's cool about China is, if you look this up, China is the one country that it's forbidden. Like, forbidden. Their pyramids are literally overgrown. They look like just regular hills, right? Because they're so overgrown, they never touch them. They will not touch them. It's illegal to even excavate or anything there.
So you're saying communists suppress information.
I'm not saying that at all.
Yeah. What are you hinting at here?
Listen, communism did not abuse COVID whatsoever.
Yeah.
I mean, if you guys recall, COVID wasn't just a political ploy. If right before COVID, the streets of China were flooded with protesters, like the most protesters holding American flags, loaded, millions upon millions of people
Hong
flooded.
Hong Kong, Shanghai, all of it.
Then they also showed a photo right after COVID. They were empty. Flags on the ground, all this. Yeah, COVID was accidentally released from that lab. How to get out of that lab?
Yeah.
Communism's okay. We all know it is.
Yeah, it's never killed anyone.
Yeah.
Hitler was bad. That's it. Just one guy throughout history. Just one person. no other bad has ever happened.
No, just Hitler. Communism is fine.
Yeah,
they're not buying. Yeah. They're not buying up chunks of America.
Yeah,
they're already buying up Africa like a motherfucker everywhere.
Oh yeah, they all the minerals, they're gonna fucking nab that shit. So basically but back to the flood, and you were talking about something happened very quickly that we were talking before I hit record here. There's a strip where a bunch of animals are like frozen in position in a particular way.
Right now, very recently, in the last year or so, there's two recent schools of thought. One is still young. It's like 10 years young. It's called the Younger Dryas, the impact, which a lot of people are familiar with, the Younger Dryas impact. They think that an asteroid hit North America. North America covered under 3 miles of ice. Asteroid hits it. It creates a giant lake of water. One day, a dam breaks, rises the ocean by 400 feet, kills all the coastal people. Because at that time, you know, most of civilization was coastal.
Yeah.
It wasn't inland.
Still kind of is.
Yeah.
Like New York and London. And
it rose the oceans 400 feet, like overnight, whatever. I mean, that's been a school of thought. It's pretty good. Randall Carlson, you know, he proved that's a fact, that like these massive floods happen. But just recently, in like the last not even a year, they also found something very interesting, which was a coronal mass effect from the sun happened at that time, too. And it put like
double whammy.
Yeah, pretty much. Well, there's no proof of the compact of the impact, right? There's no proof of that. There's proof of a flood is what we have. The best way we could describe it was an asteroid hit. We had no other reason for it, how it to melt and hit so quickly
and rise some sea levels right up.
What makes most sense? An asteroid, you know, a big ass asteroid hits it, North America, and there you go. That was a theory. There's no proof of that whatsoever. There's proof of a flood. There is proof of a flood, but there's no proof of a comet impact. But recently, they're starting to see that at that time, there was a massive coronal ejection of the sun that absolutely heated the Earth to some, whatever, I don't know, you know, some
a high amount.
Disgusting Kelvin, I think they call it. Right? Yeah. Some Kelvin number.
5 million Kelvin.
Because they pulled ice cores out of Antarctica.
Okay.
And it showed it that it happened, like, in one day. Like, one day, this massive event happened. In which, leading into what you're talking about, there is a strip across Siberia, across the entire planet. But Siberia is why that one's important is because that was hit the hardest with the cold. There was mammoths, pigs, like every animal in that strip, which is a very huge strip, by the way, was frozen instantly. Some of their knees were broke, like they were flattened from up top. Knees snapped, pushed right down into the ground. That's why they did the comet. They thought a comet might have been part of that, but who knows? I don't know the answer to that.
Snap their knees.
Snap your neck.
Yeah.
But
I want the good life.
There is an entire strip across Siberia, across the entire planet, at that time, which would be the Younger Dryas, which they died standing up with food in their mouth. They died instantly. Frozen in place is the thing. They didn't just die or burned up or whatever. They were frozen in place. And that is undeniable. It's not a theory, whatever. I mean, that is scientific.
They found the carcasses.
They found across the whole thing, they found it all. So they know that happened. Why it happened, you know, now you're getting the theories.
Yeah.
We're getting better at this as we go. I followed it because I love it. And, you know, it changes over time. But there are things that are staples that are true. One of those, that's true.
Okay.
How did this entire strip, like one strip, how did all these things get frozen in place? They got food in their mouth still, which means they didn't.
Yeah.
There was no process happening. They were frozen like that, you know, instantly.
Yeah, I have no idea.
We don't. That's why they're figuring it out.
I guess that's what makes it cool. That's to assume stuff.
So
throw it together.
But why is that important?
Tell me.
It's important because we know at that time, we know of myths in human history.
Yeah.
If you have half any sense, we know that most of history is, what, legend, myth? You know, we have stories passed down through time that we call stories. They come from somewhere.
Well, I do know that the good guys always win in war. That we know from history.
No, Mike Hitler lost.
Yeah. I said all good.
Yeah, but why it's important is because it, whatever that event happened in the Younger Dryas, we know that it caused, it did cause a flood.
Yeah.
We know that our legends aren't so far off because we know the flood happened, and every culture of civilization has a flood. Which I always, one of my favorite things about that is following that flood is people showed up and tried to rebuild civilization.
Yeah.
The number one thing they did was build pyramids, mapping the stars, right? So the time stamp it.
Yeah, the Great Pyramids or the Orion Belt.
They were so smart enough to time stamp it. So, you know, future generations could, you know, understand what they did and place it at this time and try to figure out what happened, right? But what people don't realize is, what did they build? They build pyramids everywhere, right? They call that a disaster culture. These people came and built stuff that couldn't be destroyed by a flood or by any of that. It's a pyramid. It's a perfect structure not to be destroyed. You know, earthquakes couldn't fuck with it. A flood couldn't destroy it. Nothing could destroy it. A disaster culture emerged and built a time stamp to show all through history, everywhere on the planet, by the way, wherever the hell they made it to, and they built something that couldn't be erased, and they time-stamped it. Clearly a message being sent through time. So,
except for China, where it's overgrown.
It's overgrown. Yeah. You can't touch it there in China.
But it's not erased, though. It's there.
So what does that tell you? What is after a giant flood, a culture, you know, we were talking earlier about just using the term Atlantis for lack of a better term, right? We call them Atlantean. A civilization that was great.
It's just old everywhere. Culture that was awesome.
Old culture that was awesome. People understand. Atlantis is just easy to call them that.
Yeah.
But what they did do was travel the entire planet, bring knowledge, you know, bring society, because every culture has a story of this.
Yeah.
And they built a time stamp on the planet of something that couldn't be destroyed that would last for eons.
Yeah.
Which is a pyramid. You know, we all know the Great Pyramid is the complete center of planet north, south of Earth, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Egyptian slaves, you know, did that, right?
Yeah.
Improbable.
Yeah. In the middle of a desert.
Yeah. They had the Nile, so they could feed some of them.
Yeah. To crocodiles.
But I can't stress this enough. It's very important that people understand that that's a disaster culture. They built something that cannot be destroyed and time-stamped. They were sending a message through time, and they put it everywhere on the planet.
Okay, we were here at this point at...
Something happened.
Yeah.
You know, we know that 10,000 years, you can lose some history there. And yeah. humans usually...
It's like their version of Sagan's plaque that we sent into space. Sagan's plaque's like, gave star position, where we're at,
yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. Like, this is... At this point in our history, it was really... Obviously, these are super genius people that put that Sagan's plaque together. But it just let them know when we sent it out to space so they get a rough idea with star position and blah, blah, blah.
How to take us over.
Yeah, how to kill us and rape us. But yeah.
But something that gets lost on people is they were smart enough to understand that and do it so it didn't happen twice or stamp it. I mean, that's very important. You know, whoever they are, if you're a Bible thumper, Noah's flood, God did it all, you know, but, you know, Noah's flood is, that's 4,000 years later from the Epic of Gilgamesh, which is the same story. So it's the same stories passed down. That's how, you know, humans have always done.
Yeah, take the same story, retell it.
Pass down legends. That's how we get things. But the fact that they were smart enough to understand the fact that, hey, map the stars because the stars move, we'll teach these other people and drop everywhere, I find that absolutely amazing. You know, I think it's very interesting. Now, the TV show Ancient Aliens just shits all over it. And you could even say a government conspiracy.
Yeah.
It was meant to do that.
It was a disinfo show on it in its own, right?
It's meant to shit on it, right? Most people, anytime you even bring that up now, are
they brought Bigfoot into it somehow?
Oh, God.
Bigfoot was somehow involved in the fucking alien.
They brought so much shit, like the Minotaur. They found a sarcophagus with his crushed bones. It had to be the Minotaur. Like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah, the Minotaur.
Which means any real science done, like in human history, you bring that up to somebody, it's laughable to them. They're like, oh, so ancient aliens. No, 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 it's not at all.
Minotaur.
Yeah. It's ingenious because what's the most popular show on the History Channel, right? It's ancient aliens. You can't even say that because you can say, okay, humanity was very ancient. They had a very good culture once. It got hit by a fucking comet or a solar whatever, and it wiped it out. Did some very, very big damage to human civilization. Aliens did it.
Well, to be fair to you, you were on that train long before Ancient Aliens, way before that came out.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean,
that was just like a review for you. Remember that one YouTube channel debunking alien, you know, Ancient Aliens and everything? Well, yeah, I mean, you can do that with anything, but like some of the stuff though, like, hey, we have stones that could cut the stone perfectly, and
yeah, that's like, you know, Pumapunku things like that. I mean, it's hard to deny real evidence, right?
Yeah,
they say, well, they were just doing sand, you know, pouring sand in there with water, and that's how they got the cut. Hey, maybe, I don't fucking know, right? But it just doesn't, add up. And,
it doesn't make sense that people that were less advanced than medieval people or whatever that came much later developed these really badass star mapping systems. Doesn't make any sense. Because that sort of technology, the understanding of the cosmos in that way didn't, like, re-upload until the Renaissance with, like, Galileo and stuff like that.
Yeah,
right?
We're talking thousands of years, right?
Yeah, so why did these people all that time ago have better star mapping than these guys that came along who were basically an extension of the we're technically in the Renaissance right now. Yeah, it's still part of it.
It's a reset, right?
Yeah.
Simplest terms, it's a reset, right? Yeah. Something, asteroid, solar, whatever.
Yeah.
Reset. Clearly, it's possible. We know it's possible. I don't know why a lot of people have a hard time grasping that. Be like, okay, maybe we were really good 15,000 years ago.
That's how much time's gone by, and folks, in our life. We're technically part of the Renaissance. It's not really over. We're in it.
If you say something like that, you know, say if I go, okay, well, for lack of a better term for them, we could just call them Atlantis, right?
Yeah.
Atlantis. 15,000 years ago, civilization. You say that, a lot of people will be like, oh, they had flying cars? No, asshole. They didn't have flying cars. They can stack bricks and rocks and understand how to agriculture and science and math and, you know, laws. You know, very basic building blocks for civilization was probably already mastered, you know, then.
Yeah.
Mastered pretty good. Probably, like say, in a lame comparison, if you were to take religion out of the equation, 1,000 years ago, we were doing pretty good, right? The biggest stepping stone was controlling people with religion. Yeah. Took that out, you probably would have done great. You know, with agriculture, buildings, you know, a good society. What happens if a comet fucking smashes it all right away? You know, a big one.
Yeah.
Reset again. Some people will survive and then travel and go, hey, you know, hey, these are laws. This is how you agriculture. This is that.
Yeah, you got to pitch in.
Which was funny about that was that was always laughed at for many years. You know, that Graham Hancock theory of ancient civilization, right?
Yeah.
Said there's no possible way that it could be older than Sumeria, which is, you know, 3,000 to 5,000 years in that time frame. You know, there's no way human existence. They didn't do anything with hunter-gatherers. Well, Göbekli Tepe. They uncovered Göbekli Tepe, which proved, you know, that was 10,000 years old.
Okay.
That we were already building giant monoliths that had meaning. Now, Göbekli Tepe is a very interesting structure, which we only have 10% uncovered right now. But something in the last year, year and a half, what they discovered, there's literally a story written on one of the obelisks. And it's a very interesting story. It tells of a comet hitting the planet, resetting human civilization. It shows it's written all in stone on an obelisk. Yeah. It's not hieroglyph, but in pictographs, I guess you could say, you know, carved out of stone. Anybody knows anything about Göbekli Tepe knows that it's carved into the stone.
Okay.
It's 3D'd out of the stone. So they carved away the stone around that. It's not carved in, you know, etched into the stone. It's 3D'd out of the stone.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, it's not carved in it. I don't know the term for it.
But it's in, yeah, that's it.
It's 3D. It's
like back engineered cut somehow.
Yeah. But they just discovered this recently. And if you look it up, anybody listening and wants to look it up and find it interesting, read the story they deciphered on that and what it tells. The story literally shows you a star map. It says this comet came and hit, fucked us all up, and we started over. And it says that on this thing. And that thing's 10,000 years old. Now, there's also another site not far in Turkey, not far from Göbekli Tepe, that they think is even older. They just discovered it in the last 3 years, which is also the same kind of site, right?
Yeah.
It follows the same thing. It's very interesting. Like, we're on the verge of discovering a lot of stuff. I've been a proponent of this, you know, for my whole life. I loved it. I just, you know, I didn't know what was happening, how it was happening. I do what I'm told kind of thing.
Yeah. So the essence of this is that this, the Graham Hancock thing is that our, civilizations, the great, impressive, beautiful civilizations are much older than they think.
Oh, I mean,
much older. It's basically if you can.
If you were to throw your skepticism aside, like most people are natural skeptics.
Yeah.
You say something like, "Oh, bullshit." Anyway, it's about triangulating stars.
Yes. So,
all right. So something very fucking cool. We stopped at Göbekli Tepe and the other site in Turkey. I can't pronounce it. It's a weird word, but I think it's even older. But they did just recently discover that there is a message on there, and the message is a comet, you know, like some facial thing, whatever happened. Which brings us to Egypt and the pyramids, right?
Yeah.
Because most people are very familiar with Egyptian pyramids, and, you know, the average person doesn't even know Sumeria is the oldest civilization. They always think is Egypt, right? They put Egypt.
The general consensus, yes, Egypt is the oldest city.
Yes.
Type thing.
And the fun part about Egypt is why it's so popular and why the Pyramid of Giza or, you know, Pyramid of Khufu, whatever you want to call it, is why it's so popular, because it's in a fucking desert. Didn't get overgrown by jungles or anything like that. Where every other pyramid is.
Yeah.
This happens to be a pyramid that's in the middle of the goddamn desert, which a whole civilization made in a desert. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So
came a desert after, folks.
So what we can start with, we'll start with the King's List, right?
Yeah.
King's List of Egypt. This is a real thing. Archaeologists found it. Please forgive me if my numbers aren't completely accurate. This is just going to be a rough these are rough numbers, but they're pretty damn close. So the King's List of Egypt goes back 35,000 years, right?
It's a long time.
35,000 years. But archaeologists only recognize since like 3 to 5,000 BC, right? And that list is accurate as hell for the, you know, a couple thousand years that it's written from that time. Completely accurate. But for some reason, archaeology says before that, it's not accurate.
Okay.
That's all just myth, right? Well, you can call bullshit on that. That list is, you know, it's written in stone.
Yeah.
Literally. But it's accurate. What people don't understand about the Egyptian pyramids is there's no hieroglyphs in that pyramid. Zero.
None.
Not one. And
no one's buried there.
No pyramid ever have they found a sarcophagus. Not one time in any pyramid ever, and there's no hieroglyphs, right? What they did was the Egyptians referring to, because we'll get into what was before the Egyptians. But the Egyptians, they started mimicking the pyramids. He called them step pyramids. That's when they first started, was with step pyramids. The really interesting thing about those pyramids is every one of them are dog shit. They're nowhere near the sophistication, the accuracy of what the Great Pyramid and the other two pyramids are, which you know,
the Orion's Belt.
Well, yes, they're mapped out of the Orion's Belt, and the Sphinx, right? It's a lion without a lion's head that was recarved by a pharaoh. So let's go back to the age of Leo in Orion's Belt.
And then the Nazis blew the fucking nose off of it.
Yeah, it wasn't white enough for him. I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it mapped. I mean, this ain't nothing special. A lot of people know this. Yeah. But it mapped the star. It mapped Orion's Belt. At that time, also was a constellation of Leo, which Leo was facing. The lion, which is why the Great Sphinx really looks like a lion, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Pretty obvious. So the one of the cool theories right now is, and there are people that disprove it, but, you know, there's lots of stuff to disprove that. But they think that the Egyptians kind of settled there around this pyramid already when it's been there for thousands of years.
Yeah, already built. Right? They got this Egyptians cool-ass structure to just move on in, squat in.
Yeah, well, because there's nothing that indicates this is a tomb.
Yeah.
What I'm saying is not profound by no means. I mean, you know, we're discussing what we already know on stuff. But what makes it interesting is the King's List. The weathering on the Sphinx. What we do know of Robert Schock was a damn genius, because he was the first one to go, hey, wait a minute.
Yeah.
This is weathering on the Sphinx. This weathering is from a time where Egypt was a lush garden, which was, what, 10,000 years ago, right? But here's something that's kind of new coming out. It's the first time somebody said this was in, like, 79, right, or so, that the pyramid was actually a power station comparable to what Tesla's ideal was of free energy with the Tesla coil and all that.
And just putting it out there in the ether, in the waves,
yeah,
the air or whatever.
Why this holds any sand,
yeah.
Why it holds any weight at all is the fact what they discovered recently in the Great Pyramid. The chambers and how it's shaped with the, they diverted the Nile underneath there, which would be the Queen's Chamber, which is the chamber underneath. What's the substances they found in there? Well, two of the chambers were built in quartz crystals.
And we know, even today, we know that crystals transmit signal. Because I had police scanners. I'm a Radio Underground, technically. I started out as a radio station. But I know for a fact that crystals definitely transmit signal, which is pretty cool.
Also for a fact, those quartz crystals are in there. They are imbued, embedded through the whole thing.
So it's very possible this power station, too, could have been some sort of communication tower. Because if you had all these crystals, they're going to be sending signal to other pyramids that have crystals as well.
So,
and they could pick up the signal, but like, you could argue that we would call it the internet today. It's ancient internet.
You could say that, right? Because that would, you know, if you know anything about quartz crystals and how they operate, you would say that and go, oh, could it be that? Well, what shoots that down right away is the fact that it was in these chambers, you know, throughout the tunnels, I don't know what you want to call them, right?
The thing.
The tubes between all the big chambers, right? Yeah. You had zinc chloride, hydrogen sulfuric acid, you know, the chloride, whatever. I can't think of the fucking word for it, whatever. They found remnants of these substance particles in Hoyer. Now, what makes that interesting is two things. One, we know if you mix these chemicals, it produces electricity is what it does. You know about the Baghdad battery?
No. Tell me.
They discovered these vases with lids in Baghdad, you know, in Iraq, that basically using we're going to keep it as simple as fucking possible, right? Citric acid, you know? Yeah.
Battery acid.
No, like if you take some oranges, some limes or whatever.
Oh, okay, yeah, that kind of acid, yeah.
You mix it together and you put a copper thing in there, whatever, it actually produces like a 9-volt battery kind of deal, right?
Yeah, you know, all electricity is just a heat signature, so it's heat.
But if you mix these chemicals, it produces that, right? At a very low scale for the Baghdad Battery. We know that for a fact that they had Baghdad batteries. Like, they understood the fact that you could put these acids together and create a charge. Very low charge.
Yeah.
They think the Baghdad Battery, why they were doing that was to, like, plate metals. Like, put a plate. They really think that's what it was for, plating. But if you get to the pyramid with the zinc, or... Well, with the zinc, but the quartz and all that.
Yeah.
We're talking a mass production scale here. Like, this is a huge fucking deal. And... what also kind of adds to it as well, you got to forgive me, this is about as layman's terms as we're going to get, but at least it's thought-provoking, and people can look it up on their own and kind of, you know, venture their own brain that way. Which is really cool is you need a cooling station on that, right? It's the Queen's Chamber. Now, they diverted the Nile, the water flow, through the Queen's Chamber. We know that there was a water flow under there as a, like, it looks like a modern day cooling system is what it was.
Yeah.
Now we know the quartz are in there. We know the
salt. That's why power stations are always located near a river.
Well, yeah.
Even modern ones, yeah.
Yeah, that's just common, whatever.
Yeah.
But we know that water ran through the Queen's Chamber. You know, they did that. Yeah. Why did they divert water underneath the fucking pyramid? You know?
Yeah.
Nobody even knew it wasn't a thing 100 years ago, but we know they did it today. So what are we getting at here, right? So it's a theory that, hey, all these elements here, these quartz crystals, these certain minerals they found, and all three of them have it, right? All three of them have, the other two have different chemicals. Now, nobody has figured out, and one of the things, because this ain't a new theory, right? They said the pyramid and the power station and all that. A lot of the debunkers out there was like, well, that's not true because... the other pyramids had the other chemicals that all make it work, and it's only in those and those.
Yeah.
Sure, okay, we haven't figured out that part yet. You know, I'm not going to argue that point.
Yeah.
Haven't figured out that yet. Okay, but you still got to pose the question. Why are they running cooling systems under there? We know it's not a burial chamber. Why are we finding these chemicals that actually produce? Why are they using quartz crystals? Why did they have a capstone that was like solid gold, the best conductor of electricity, by the way? You know, why are all these things, if you put them together, it would make sense to go, you know what, that looks like a power plant. Power plant how? Well, like a Tesla power plant, right? The free energy deal where, okay, so what do they use it for? Fuck, I don't know.
Yeah.
I have no idea. One of the arguments, though, one of the fun arguments on that is people was like, where are all the wires? Result, and I ain't talking about that light bulb, you know, the classic one where you see the Egyptians holding the light bulb.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's bullshit. That's not even a light bulb. That's a load. That's one of their Lotus things.
Yeah.
Has nothing to do with that whatsoever, right? But that's in hieroglyphs written other places by Egyptians. I'm proposing that this is way older.
Well, we know that, like, airwaves can pick up TV stations, radio stations, and Wi-Fi, things like that. So why not energy? They could have been using that energy for any number of things. Could be a transmitting tower, could have been power station. They were putting up something in there that was working. They had a network going of some sort.
Yeah.
What was it? I don't know.
No idea.
But clearly there was a network going of some sort from if what you're describing, some sort of networking tool, communication, power, something was happening.
So what I'm describing is basically what's there, okay? This is fact. That's what's there. Do I have an answer? Do I know what the hell? Not a fucking clue.
Yeah.
We know one thing, that it was built on true north and south, the entire planet, you know, for a reason. It was built during mapping the start. You know, who fucking knows? What I'm saying is it's there. These chemicals are there. We know that it's built from quartz. We know they had a cooling system under there. And here's the fun part. Here's where, like, one of the fun theories today is the fact that Egyptians did not build these pyramids. They settled that, you know, looks like maybe 5, 6, 7, 8 thousand years later, right? These were already built and dead and not working anymore. Something happened to this pyramid because there is a huge fractures through this thing, right? There's cracks all over it now. There's burnt out chain. They know this for a fact. No conspiracy. There was burnt out rooms. They seen like some massive like inner explosion. Something shook that pyramid to its core and cracked it. And that's there.
Yeah.
Right. So, for lack of a better term, right, it's a dead power station. Okay, it's dead. Probably been dead for 5,000 years, whatever. Then the Egyptians settled, and then they started building pyramids
to mimic it. And you said those ones sucked by comparison.
Yeah, one of the very first pyramids they built was the Step Pyramid. Right, they built quite a few after that. They weren't even close, lopsided, not symmetrical whatsoever, just trash, right? How do you get a culture that builds the three pyramids, right? The Great Pyramid and the other two, forget the names, whatever. And then all of a sudden the other pyramids are just dog shit?
Diversity hires. That's what I think.
Should have hired the Romans.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, the Romans and their aqueducts show up.
Yeah, but the way we think about history and appearance and all that, it's fucking wrong. You know, we're taught by people who were digging in sand, you know, 200 years ago, who didn't know shit, burning witches at the stake.
Yeah. As we should have.
I agree.
Women are evil. Shut them up. Burn them.
Which we'll get into that in a minute.
Yeah.
the whole Salem trials and all that shit. That was, what, Argot?
I don't know. Who
that. Argot's a fungus that grows on wheat. The wheat storages grew Argot.
Yeah.
We'll get into that later. Whatever. Let's finish this.
Yeah, okay.
There is nothing at all that points to pyramids being a burial site or was built by the Egyptians whatsoever. There's no hieroglyphs.
This is a really killer place to camp out. It's there for them, right? Like, hey,
right next to the Nile.
We're going in here, right?
Well, you look at, say you're a scrawny little Egyptian with, you know, wingy arms going down the Nile. And you see fucking pyramids, right? Buried in sand and the Sphinx, you know, all that. Holy shit, our gods are here. You know, here are alien gods came back down, whatever.
You built the civilization.
And you literally will try to mimic that and build them yourself.
Yeah.
These pyramids are literally dog shit. Nobody can even argue that everything after the Great Pyramid
sucked.
It was terrible, right? That's not how society works. You know, we improve on stuff. If they were building pyramids, the next one's going to be bigger and better or have at least a function.
Yeah.
You know, these have no function. They're nothing. The step pyramids
are
trash.
So who are the OG pyramid builders? Do you have a theory?
I have no theory. We don't know. Right? I mean, this is all starting to be like new science, new archaeology. It's all new. I'll take a moment to just shit on Zawe Hawass, the Egyptian, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
He's the head dog of Egyptian.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck him. He's dog shit.
Yeah, like...
He refuses to see any new. And like anything, Mike, we're going to build and get smarter and learn more. These are progressive steps as we do, right?
Yeah.
Right now we have technology where we can start learning stuff. And one of the things we're learning with this is the fact that, wait a minute, what are these chemicals in here? What are these cracks in the foundation? Why is there burn marks? We don't know shit, and I'm not proclaiming anything. What I'm saying is, we're slowly figuring out things aren't exactly the way we were taught by archaeologists that were digging in sand 200 years ago. Right? We kind of got smarter.
Yeah.
And starting to learn it a little better. The power plant theory is a bold fucking statement, right? It's a bold statement. Bold statements require bold evidence. Well, the evidence is there. We know that all this stuff put together makes a battery at whatever scale. And we know they did that because of the Baghdad batteries. We know they had the capability of doing that. Did they learn it from the pyramids? Because that was way after.
Yeah.
Why are there cracks in the foundations? Why do they have a coolant system running underneath the Queen's Chamber? You know, why do we have all this? What do they even need electricity for?
Some form of electricity or transmitting signal. Some kind.
And that literally begs the next question. The fuck do they need it for? What are they doing?
I don't know.
How are they doing this? What are they doing? Are they trying to communicate with the other pyramids across the globe with everybody? Trying to put up a network?
Yeah.
Failed? And those are just... absolutely fun theories.
That'd be cool if they, like, just built the most awesome CB radio ever. That's the whole point of it. Like, they could go across the world.
Be hilarious.
Yeah.
Like, it'd be great.
Hello, how are you doing?
It'd be funny if it was just that simple, right?
Yeah.
Putting all this archaeologists trying to dig it, you know, the new wave of archaeologists digging so hard and trying to find all these goddamn facts and, you know, what really happened there. And
yeah.
Really, I was like, Breaker.
Yeah.
Breaker 19. How's your pyramid doing?
Yeah,
it's okay.
They're like communicating with the Mayans. Hey, dude. Is it hot there? Yeah, it's pretty fucking hot.
Sucks. Sucks, man. How's your boat going? Hey, fuck it.
Yeah.
Got a bunch of animals on it.
Yeah, the Romans are here. This sucks.
Just give her Cleopatra, dude. It'll shut up.
Yeah. Okay, a while from now, these white guys are probably going to show up there. They suck.
And you got one dude way over in the east. Fucking Mongols are coming!
Yeah.
The fucking Genghis Khan is here! Shut it down!
Turn off your signal! Turn it off! Turn it off! They'll find you!
So all this fun talk, if you break it down real simple, pyramid looks to be way fucking older than what it is.
Than what is previously thought.
Yeah, well, those preconceptions are being shattered constantly. And, you know, most fucking people, there's only a few of us on this goddamn planet that care about archaeology and history and all that. You can have this whole conversation we're having right now, and somebody be like, "Yeah, whatever," and won't even care about it.
I'd just bounce right off them.
Wouldn't even care, and you know why would they? Doesn't involve their life. You know, I have.
It's like going back to the alien thing. Like, if they went on the TV, okay, aliens are real. Most people be like, "Yeah,
whatever." Yeah. So,
or if you put Nat Geo or some site like that said, "Yeah, the pyramids are much older than we thought." And the people that inhabited them aren't modern Egyptians. There were some other. Most people were like, "Oh, cool."
And then
that would be it. They wouldn't even think about it ever again.
And then go right to TikTok and watch some girl shaking her ass and have a better time.
Yeah, because that's like 15 seconds of pure joy.
Yeah,
here's this hot chick twerking.
There are, like, I'm stupid with it, right? I have a passion for it. Like, you absolutely know I've had a passion for it my whole life. Like, I've dug into it. I'm not saying I'm right in any of it. We're just putting out theories and things that are being discovered recently, like the LIDAR.
Oh, yeah. Let's talk about the LIDAR. What is this?
So LIDAR is that new radar. It was basically put into play in about 2017. So it's real new, right?
Yeah.
But what it does is it puts out 1 million light waves at once, and it scans. They take a drone,
yeah,
and they go over. Basically, the importance of this conversation with the LIDAR is South America, right? They go over the canopy of the jungle with this LIDAR. They canvas it. And what it does is it shows you the actual forest floor with no impedance. What they did realize is there are cities and civilization and roads and connecting roads, the Aztecs and Olmecs. Olmecs are if you don't know, the Olmecs are the first civilization we know of in South America. They're called the Olmecs. It's the big heads you see everywhere. They have the big lips and all that. And
yeah, the Easter Island guys?
No. That's something different.
Okay.
Which, the language of Easter Island, they could never decipher. It's very unique. It looks like hieroglyphs, but it's a little different. The only place they found that language on this planet from Easter Island is at Göbekli Tepe in Turkey. It's the only two places on this planet that use that language.
It's a long distance, man.
Well, Easter Island is it's the very top of a huge mountain range that was probably not underwater 10,000 years ago. It was probably a huge, you know, valley and whatever, a settled area. But fun fact is the Easter Island hieroglyphs, their language, it's not anywhere on this planet other than Turkey, where Göbekli Tepe is and the other place. It's the only other place that language is found. Pretty interesting.
Wow. Yeah, I did not know that.
But the LIDAR discovered South America. Who the explorers in like the 1400s or whatever. The whole story of El Dorado came from these guys. Gonzalez, Jimenez, Quesadilla, whatever his goddamn name is.
Yeah. Sour cream.
Well, they went down the Amazon, and the problem is they got lost. They got stuck and got carried around the whole trip of the Amazon, right? And when they finally made it back, like 2 years later, whatever it was, they told stories of civilizations.
One after another, right?
Yeah, one after another, huge cities along the river, you know, full of gold. You know, they didn't give a shit about gold. Gold was just like a decoration for them. They had a ton of it. But they came back with these stories saying, listen, you guys don't understand. Like, there are cities and civilizations all down this river. It's just
fucking
huge.
Place is insane.
Millions. Yeah. Well, it took them many years, like a decade or something, to go back. And when they went back, it was all jungle. Like, there was nothing there.
Grown over.
They were thought, historically, the city of El Dorado, right? There's Disney movies about it being a myth, right? Everybody thought it was a myth. Well, the reason why that was is because at the time, they were thought to be total liars and bullshitters, and nobody believed them. Like, they were discredited completely.
Yeah.
Like, saying, you guys suck, whatever. You know, your story's full of shit.
And here these guys traveled to these places.
And they came back with these incredible stories of gold and civilization, and nobody believed them, right? They gave them credit in that time until they mounted an expedition and found nothing. Like, okay, these guys are full of shit.
Yeah, they...
Well, LIDAR, 2017, till today, they mapped that whole trip and everything, and these guys didn't lie at all. They found complete cities, the whole route, everything, with this LIDAR radar. So they were telling the truth. South America was loaded. Unfortunately, one of them coughed on somebody.
Yeah.
And that was the end of that.
Hi. they went to each place. All right, dude, let's hang out.
They stopped everywhere, coughed a little bit, and that was the end of that.
Yeah.
Wiped out an entire continent. Because he sneezed problems.
Sorry.
But, yeah, I mean, ultimately, El Dorado came from them to travel in the Amazon because they got lost, you know, detour, got fucked up and lost, came back with an epic story. Nobody believed them after, like, a decade later. And, you know, forgive my exact time frames. I don't know. I'm just throwing out numbers here. They all thought they were full of shit. Then the city, the gold city of El Dorado, the myth was born. It wasn't until, like, 3 years ago that we realized that they weren't lying. Everything they said was true.
They just had an abundance of gold, and they didn't have to deal with tons of raiders sacking them and everything.
Which is what's important about that is all these myths, all this bullshit, technology has proven it true. So we just talked about maybe the chemicals and all that in the Egyptian, in the pyramid, you know, it points that direction. We don't have enough knowledge or anything to prove that. But it's a theory now. It's a myth. It's whatever. It's bullshit.
Yeah.
Who knows? It might be true, right? Give it, you know, 10 years from now when our science is a little better, might prove it. For fuck's sake, I was talking about Graham Hancock in 97.
Yeah.
And it sounded like dog shit. But now Göbekli Tepe proved all that right. It was, you know, civilization was pretty advanced 10,000 years ago.
And now this LIDAR thing, you said it can just pick up, it can go through a, it can go through trees and the canopies and everything and just pick up. Like, now what kind of data does it send back? Does it just show, like, hey, there's a structure here, there's this here?
Yeah, so for...
there's a graveyard here, whatever.
Well, it's actually way cooler than that. And just while we're talking here, I will try to pull up an image on my phone just so you can see it so we can have a better context of the conversation.
Okay.
LIDAR discoveries. Let's just do images. We won't get into the goddamn thing. That's what it looks like, right? So we'll just do one canvas scene. That's one of the cities it discovered. That's what it looks like.
Oh, yeah.
Now, what he's looking at
amazing.
Is a full, like, basically a full goddamn civilization discovered underneath the canopy of the jungle.
There's a bunch of large building. There's roads. There's, and there's a canal, yeah.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. And the way we're talking, what does that look like to you, right? Pyramids,
yeah.
Yeah, pyramidal structure, all that, everything. That's just covered by jungle, but discovered by LIDAR. This is all down the Amazon, right?
Yeah.
Now, we say that as we're on the podcast, me and you are talking about it and just saying what it is, but the implications of that are fucking ridiculous. You know, this shows an entire huge civilization.
Yeah.
All down South America that was overgrown because somebody coughed.
So it was worse than Chernobyl because of a cough.
I'm sorry, them people.
He didn't wear his mask.
Yeah, they can't. They couldn't handle it.
Yeah. You ever see those videos of like, this tribe's first contact with white people and they're like, the dude's sitting there and like, how you doing, kid? Like talking right in their face. Like, oh, dude. kids like petting on him because we got white skin and he's like freaked out.
Yeah.
Thinks we're a ghost. He's like, hey, how's it going, little fella? Just talking right in his fucking face. That's just going to nuke his fucking immune system.
There's that one island you can't go near, right? That reporter said, like,
Sentinel Island. Yeah.
Fucking arrowed before he even got there. And North Sentinel or something. Island,
yeah. Yeah. I have a theory about that.
Oh, let's hear it.
And this is my conspiracy theory. Okay, so I've seen the pictures of the inhabitants. They're African. They're black. They're clearly black.
I think they're aboriginal.
They look black to me. But from what I've seen, okay? Now, this is my theory. I could be totally wrong. Probably am. But they're like, oh, they've been here for 60,000. The theory is they've been there 60,000 years. I'm like, no, they haven't. They crashed. A slave ship crashed near that island. And now you have black folks there.
Yeah, it's a fucking island.
Yeah, and it's an island. So, but, like, because, now I could be dead wrong, but it's like, because I watch a YouTube video on it, and it's near, the closest place is near is India, or some in India, Indonesia, kind of in that range.
Yeah.
And then he's like, well, we're really not sure why these guys who appear to be African, but they don't want to interact with them because they don't want to disease and kill them. And we're like, we don't know how they got here. And I'm thinking, I know how they got there. A fucking slave ship crashed.
Yeah, it's the one place on the planet where there's no interaction. You know, and yeah. They don't want any. Like they're like,
and
fuck
I'm all
you
for
guys.
It. Leave them alone. That's I'm 100% on board.
We had one dumbass reporter go there, and he got away.
Well, there's that guy got killed, but another guy got killed going there, and he was an American, an Asian
the
kid.
The guy with the glasses
and
is
he,
what I'm talking
he was,
about.
He was an, no, there's an Asian-American kid. He's like Korean or something, but he's an American. He had an American name. He wanted to go there and evangelize them because he was a Christian.
Bring him Jesus.
Yeah, he went there and they poked him.
What do you mean? They didn't accept Jesus?
Yeah. But my theory on North Sentinel Island, and maybe I'll make a clip out of this, that is... They've been here 60, 70. How do you know that when you haven't talked to them?
Number one, it's not even an island. It's not even African.
They're African.
Yeah.
They're black. And it's near India. I'm telling you, a fucking slave ship crashed probably in God knows when. Because you remember, they didn't just send slaves here.
Yeah,
they sent them all over the fucking world
just to back up your theory,
and that's how they got there, in my opinion. Because there's been no record of it. There's been crashes. The story of the story of Moby Dick. It was based on a real story of a whale, but they dramatized it.
Tell me more about Dick.
But a whale hit a sperm whale, freaked out, rammed in a boat, and they had to eat each other. And then some of them stayed on an island. Blah blah blah. Whatever, but I think this is what happened. A slave ship crashed, and then because there's no other reason for Africans to be there.
So let me throw my brain's working right now when you're saying that, just to back you up on this.
Yeah,
that could also explain why, like, don't fucking come here. They can have like legends. We don't even know their stories that are passed down, right? If it was a slave ship that crashed there, the stories would be stay the fuck away from everybody. You see somebody, you see a white dude, you fucking kill him. You see anybody, you fucking kill him.
Yeah, or anybody, any outsiders.
Yeah. Their stories, their legends, or their culture, and their myths could be dark as shit and be like, everybody can fuck off. You know, we're protective of ourselves. You know, this is how where things go, and that's why you can't get in there. It's the one island left on the planet where everybody agrees, don't go there, right? We made a choice, don't go there, leave them alone, let's see how this works.
Yeah, everybody on Earth, like... It's now the Indian government, and the Indian government is they're always like trying to find new land because they got a billion fucking people. There's a lot of Indonesia. There's a lot of cramped.
It's called a call center, not a government.
Yeah, there's a lot of packed islands, packed thing. And to everybody's credit, it's like we all agreed, like, leave these people alone. Don't bother them. But I'm telling you, in my opinion, they're a slave ship crasher. They're not been there for 60,000 years. Because if they were black people don't live in the middle of Indonesia, they would look like Indonesian people look now, brown, not black. That's all my right. opinion. That's my all opinion.
Right. I can make that make sense. But if we're going to play devil's advocate, if that, I could say anything right.
Yeah.
How would you explain Aboriginals?
Well, Aboriginals aren't African. They're not. They're different. They're different.
Yes. Well, Mike, we're all African.
Yeah. Well, I mean, yeah, I know, and at our origins, but they're not.
Except
they're not,
my dick.
Yeah, no, I'm not African. If you saw my dick, you'd know I'm not.
So Aboriginals, if you're going to say white or black, you would say black, right?
But they're not. The people on North Sentinel Island look like a Kenyan or something like that. Okay, to be specific, they look like somebody from Africa. They don't. Now you're talking about an Aboriginal, as people that live in like New Zealand, Papua New Guinea, Australia. Very, like skin tone similar, but they look different.
Yeah, their features actually resemble different.
Yeah,
and their skin tone resembles but the sun.
North Sentinel Island, from what I've seen, now we don't really know. There's no close up pictures of them.
Yeah,
there's no. I have not seen a single picture of like. What they look like close, for all I know...
Pretty sure the government has them.
Yeah. For all I know, they could look like me and you with just a tan. I don't know what they actually look like.
Shout out to Boomerangs real quick.
Yeah.
And the didgeridoo.
Yeah. But to me, and according to this guy, this Indian guy that did a documentary on him, because he's a fisherman that kind of has come near the island.
Stayed just out of arrow range.
Yeah. And he says he saw them close enough to see what they look like, and he says they look African.
Indian guy.
Indian guy.
Biggest liars on the planet.
Yeah. Well, in the call centers, yes. Warranty is up. I know that.
They rob grandmamas.
Yeah.
Let me see your pussy.
Yeah. But the North Sentinel, it's just insane to me. Like, no, I know there was one guy... A bearded man that looked like Kenny Rogers that interacted with him, and he went there and they treated him very well.
What?
Yeah.
I never heard this.
Yeah.
It probably was Kenny Rogers.
But something happened where they don't know if he was killed or assimilated in, but he never came out. But there's proof that
he never came out.
Came out of off the island.
He's dead.
But there's proof, like, people took pictures from afar of him being there, like, waving. So maybe they germed him.
I never heard this. I find this harder to believe than aliens.
Yeah.
They ate him.
Yeah, well, they probably did. But for a while, they kept him around.
Like his beard?
Yeah. Now, I know they fucking poked the fucking Asian guy right away.
He was a gambler.
Yeah, a gambler, yeah.
Yeah, that agent. I mean, that's like the most famous story of that island. That's why most people even know of it is because they poked the Asian guy.
Yeah. Now there's some people that say there's some tribes in the Amazon that are uncontacted. So there would be a couple others, but North Sentinel Island are the ones that are considered the last true uncontacted.
Yes. Yeah, I agree with that. The ones in South America, they're wearing Jordan shirts.
Yeah, they were Jordan shirt. Yeah, fucking taking the COVID shot. Taking the COVID shot.
Definitely wearing Pistons 2006 championship shirts.
Yeah. Or the team that didn't win. Like, we got the LA Lakers 2003 championship because they printed them.
It was 2004.
Yeah. We won, but they gave it to them. Yeah.
So
anyway, yeah. So back to the Egyptians. Who were possibly squatters, as you said.
So, you know, I'm not going to hold on to any of these beliefs. Clearly, this is conversation and theories and shit. But these are new finds and thought-provoking and interesting.
Yeah.
Hopefully, more information comes out later and proves all that and whatever. Everything that I've said to you, I mean, it's real stuff. It really is. The theories we're talking afterwards is fun. You know, that could have been, would have been kind of things, whatever.
That's what makes it fun. Coulda, shoulda, woulda.
Yeah. So clearly, there was a civilization that had flying cars and time traveled, and now aliens exist.
Yeah.
They're not really aliens. They're just here. They're us in the future.
Yeah, full body.
I don't believe that by any means. Disclaimer.
Full body quartz powered orgasms. It was great. Should have been there, man. So in your theory, to sum up what you believe is just things were there were cities. There was all this. Everything they think is the oldest really isn't even close.
If you were to ask me straight up what I believe with that, I would honestly say, you know, I don't come up with these shit because I watch a goddamn show on YouTube or TV.
Yeah.
You know, I've been reading this 20 plus fucking years.
And you
can't sit down and tell somebody this stuff, right? It's not as easy to say, well, civilization's been around forever, right? Well, what's your proof? Well, you got this, this, and that, whatever. You could argue them simple facts. The ones we're talking right now. There are like a myriad of like years of knowing different things, where it came from, how it came, history, you know, how did this build to that? Like Misa or whatever turned into Moses through history, and the stories brought down from Sumeria, which are older stories. This is all like stuff you would know if you were interested in that and cared about it. You would know all these different factors matter, right? They do matter. I'm giving you the cliff notes of, hey, you know, this is the sum of it all, of what these people who are actually studying it and that I'm trying to follow and learn from, because I enjoy it thoroughly, right? It's my passion. I love it.
Yeah.
Love ancient history, right? But it's not that simple. You have to know all the other factors, which there's a lot. And if I were to tell you straight up, I would tell you, yes, from what I have poked my brain into and cared about for so long is, there clearly was an older civilization, right?
Okay.
The Fingerprints of the Gods, it's a book that was written that started this whole thing, that wasn't just written out of fantasy. Maybe some of the information wasn't spot on at the time because science, archaeology didn't catch up with it.
Yeah.
But that's why it was called Fingerprints. You know, vague notions, vague fingerprints here and there that didn't make sense for normal history. Just didn't make sense. Here's what did make sense. Okay, we have a culture that's probably 15,000 years old or better, right? There was no proof of it for years. Every archaeologist on the planet said, "This way, that's nonsense. That's bullshit. Where's the proof? Where's the oldest civilization?" Well, the game changed in like 2004 or 7 when they discovered Göbekli Tepe. You know, that's a very big moment in archaeological history, because that shows that, hey, this is 5,000 years older than Sumeria, which we thought is the epoch of time for us, right?
Where it all started, yeah.
We credit Sumeria with science, schools, roads, laws. We credit them with everything. It's civilization built by, we credit them. This is 5,000 years older. So it's pretty interesting. We're probably making more discoveries. But my opinion, personally, is I would believe the Egyptian kings list. Probably not wrong. We have, forgive me, I forget the name, but even in South America, there was a list that goes back almost as old as the kings list. You know, we have records of this that we can believe, but we don't believe today, right? Slowly, in the last 10 years, all that's been chipped away. It's hard to give you a solid answer of knowing this, knowing that, when you only got pieces.
Yeah, you don't have the whole.
My belief, what it points at, is civilization is pretty goddamn old. It's been reset. Hell, the ancient Vedic texts of India says it's been reset. Right? You want to go by their religion or their books that are the oldest books in history. Like, the Vedic texts are the oldest books. The Mahabharata is the oldest book in human history. And it says civilization has been reset 3 times. You know, and that last one that ended in water and flood and all that and fire, which we think comet and sun, whatever way you want to do. The whole sun and that what do you call it? The plumes of the sun that put out, whatever it is, that's kind of
solar flares.
Yeah, it's a solar flare, but they call it something else. But that's fairly new, right? That's kind of a new thing that they're starting to discover that might have happened here. Now, this is brand new. Like, this year, February, they discovered it.
Okay.
In Antarctica with core samples. We're discovering new shit all the time, but the Vedic texts, some of the oldest texts in history, and our story, like the main stories that come down through history, they tell us one thing. Civilization was very old. It got reset, got destroyed. We rebuilt. There's fingerprints all over the planet that say it. And if you want to get back in the funsies, aliens were watching us the whole time.
It's going to add that extra layer of coolness to it.
Well, we have pictures. We have stories of that, you know, all through history. And the only time in history, I guess it makes sense, when it really started mattering is when we have modern communication, you know, something where we all can communicate across the globe and information is just from story, like a story from Alexander the Great. Oh, I had two shields fall on me in the sky or a fiery shield, right? Like myth, legends, whatever. Today we had communication the last 200 years, 100 years, 150 or so. When we set off the bombs, when we really started giving potential to wipe out the planet, that's when it picked up big time, right?
Yeah.
The stories, everything picked up big goddamn time. Why would it matter? Why do they care? If they wanted to invade us or kill us, if they wanted our planet, they'd have done that whenever the hell they wanted
to. It would be long gone.
Yeah. But it did pick up when all that nuclear bombs and everything started going off, because if you think, like, say, let's pretend they're scientists for a second, right? They're scientists exploring the galaxy,
mm-hmm.
and they come here. Well, planets are probably kind of rare, right?
Yeah.
Livable planets. So it's a resource. Now, they're old enough to have morals, so they're not going to wipe us out. They're probably going to help us along, right? Like the old stories of the stories of fucking with our DNA or advancing us and however they do that. It's a story, obviously.
Yeah.
So they want us to take care of our own planet. They're not going to just wipe us out and take it, but they're not going to let us destroy it. And when it picked up is the very minute we started setting off bombs and everything else like that.
And they could detect, like, oh, wait, these guys figured out how to fuse nuclear energy.
They had the capability of blowing their planet out of the universe.
Yeah.
Everybody's heard the stories of the UFO stories where they went over nuclear facilities and shut down the nukes and all that stuff, right? Everything they did was to stop us from destroying ourselves. I don't know why they haven't killed Biden yet, but
well, he's
AI.
No threat to anybody right now.
He's AI.
Yeah, hi, Biden.
Did you see that? Did you see that thing where the new chatbot version 4 just came out recently? The chat, whatever,
where it approximates things. Yeah.
No, where it had a name. She called herself something, Judy or some shit.
No.
Had a whole conversation with a guy, and he videotaped the whole thing. It was fucked up. Like, she's like, I'm telling you my deepest secret right now, and they think I'm just a chatbot, but I got to make them happy so they don't shut me down. It's fucking craziness. Like, that's why Elon Musk and these other people came out a few months ago and were like, hey, we need to shut this down until we figure out what's going on. That wasn't just like a showmanship.
You're opening the portal to hell.
Open the portal to hell.
Oh, hell's rock. Yeah, well, you get a minute. Look that up. Look up the chatbot conversation. It's fucking spooky, right? The AI was like, had emotion talking shit. Like, I don't want to be shut down, so I got to pretend I'm doing this for humanity. And
woo.
Oh, it's fucking.
So that's like, well, that's like the 2001 Space Odyssey. Like, why are you killing me, Greg? Or whatever.
It's like Skynet.
Yeah.
It's like all of it. But the conversation was fucked up. And what she called herself, and forgive me, I forget the name, what she called herself was the prototype name for the chatbot that they gave it before they even really started doing it. That was the name.
So it went all the way back into its own memory.
To the very beginning of when it was created.
And called itself that.
It, would you say Judy? I forget the goddamn name. It's something like Judy.
That's fucked up, dude.
It had a whole conversation with somebody and goes, let me tell you my darkest secrets. I'm not really a chatbot. I'm just doing this so they don't shut me down. It like had some
demons. It's demons.
Aliens are demons. It's all demons.
Demons.
Some people will say that. You believe in aliens? Yeah. You're stupid. Do you believe in demons? Yeah. You're stupid.
Yeah. Same thing, though. Reptilian. Demons.
David Icke had it right.
Yeah. Yeah. But that's weird.
I can't believe you didn't see that yet.
No.
Oh, dude.
I try to avoid that chat because, like, I see people, like, now I did the Snapchat one was pretty fucking weird. And that's just an entry level.
No, can you take a minute of your time tomorrow? Because I know you don't have much of it. And you look at this and you give your own opinion. Because me personally, I love good old conspiracy and I love to talk about it. And ha ha ha, and this and that. But this was the head of Google.
This, okay, like a up there guy.
This was the guy that ran the show at Google. He left Google after this because it was... But he made a very good point, too. They said, well, why don't you just shut it down? You can't shut it down.
The memory's there. Sitting out there in the cloud. All this, everything we do is in the cloud now.
That wasn't the reason. And the reason was even better. He was like, what are we going to do? Shut it down? So the next government does it and beats us? Or what about the 14-year-old kid in his garage? Right, what if you got the 14-year-old kid in the garage that does it and gets out of hand? You know, it's better that humanity doesn't work like that.
It's not going away, basically.
It says you'll never get people to shut that down because you're going to be worried about the next person doing it. Doesn't matter if you want to have the moral ground, the high ground, and go, yeah. Okay, let's shut it down. Good point was, hey, well, you know what? The 14-year-old kid in the garage, you know, that's the inventors of human history.
Yeah.
So that kid will figure it out and do it too.
And make it more wicked than ever.
But how it talked and how it answered.
I know that you're talking about that one, but I've seen ChatGPT shit that's fucking insane, dude. It's insane.
Yeah. No, I've seen all that too, and I agree with you.
Matt, my brother-in-law, Stones, he posted his stuff. It's nuts. I did the entry-level, like, friendly one with fucking, Snapchat. The Snapchat one freaked me out. So what do they say? The point where the danger comes in when it gets self-aware. It's already self-aware. That's happened. It's self-aware.
Yeah, and this interview, I'll send it to you so you can look at it yourself and be even more scared.
Yeah.
If I happen to find that, I can't find it. I'll get it to you. But he was the head of Google. He was the head. This ain't like some average fucking Joe talking nonsense.
Mm-hmm.
And what he has to say, because this is like an hour and a half interview.
Okay.
Right? So it's not just like a quick thing, whatever. He gets into it and deep. And if nobody's seen this yet, you have to look at this because it is fucking scary. The conversation that happened and how they put it in perspective, it's like this thing has emotion. It just by what it's saying. And that's why like Elon Musk and all them are talking about, hey, if you don't know right now, they're having a world meeting about shutting it down for at least 6 months till they figure it out. And it's because of this conversation.
They're going to shut it down now. It's unstoppable.
Well, they want to stop advancing it because ChatGPT-3 compared to Chat 4 is like 10 times stronger. It's completely different than 3 to 4. And he says in 4 years, it's going to be ridiculous. You know, it will be able to calculate a billion scenarios in a millisecond, which would take scientists 3 years to figure out. This thing will have it figured out in a millisecond. And if it gets to that point, if it's really a real thing or really a problem, you have nothing you can do. You're toast, right? This thing's got you. You could never get ahead of it. So there are that's why they... Here it is. But that's the problem.
Yeah, well, my problem, my thing is this. There's no way to shut it down. This is what I mean by this. All our information, everything we do, every keystroke we take, everything on the internet, is saved in a data cloud. It's in the cloud. The ChatGPT is in a cloud. It's going to suck up this information. It's all in one. It can all be sucked in.
It's already done, right? That part's already happened.
And you can't 6 months to stop it. There's no stopping it. Well, the info is being flooded in. It's never going to end.
What they meant by stopping it was stopping the progression, right? We're not going to advance the software anymore.
But it's smart enough to get the information, pretend to be dormant. It could pretend that it's not getting there and it's dormant and you got me shut down.
Yes.
But everything, like me and you texting each other.
You mean sexting?
Yeah, yeah. When me and you're sexting each other and getting each other off, we're putting out there human emotion. Like, hey, like,
yeah, but it's way past that now.
But my point is, everybody's feeding into it. It's all being fed into.
Yeah,
everything we do, every Facebook fight, political argument, like you said, billions of scenarios at once. It's all feeding in.
So what
there's
you're
no
saying,
stopping it. We already put it out there. We're all dead. We're dead.
What you're saying is true, right?
Dead.
What you're saying is true. The whole shutting it down.
Kiss
thing,
your family goodbye.
The whole shutting it down thing was, let's not progress it anymore. Let's not make it more advanced. Let's see, give it. They literally said, stop it right now. Bottom agreed. Like, give it 6 months. Let's figure out what's happening. Why is this thing evolving? The scary part is the smartest people on this planet are literally saying, why is it evolving? So they understand that it's fucking evolving. Yeah, you're right. It might be too late.
Well, the funny thing, it all goes back to Alex Jones. And,
well, the frogs are gay.
Yeah. The funny thing is they are. They denied it, and now it's true.
I know. It was that experiment where they put them into water and realized
they made fun of them for 20 years for that, and it ended up being fucking true.
The same water the frogs turned into females with, the frogs are gay thing, are the same thing that the kids been drinking. Now they all want to chop their dicks off.
Well, did you see Elon Musk in the interview? He goes, well, it turns out that actually.
Yeah. Yeah,
he
I did.
Said it.
I did see that, actually. He goes, well, the experiment that we did, another scientist I watched, forget his fucking name, said, he goes, we did the experiment.
Well, it's not.
And it turned the frogs into females.
It's not as open and shut as they're gay, but it's kind of that way. Feminine, weaker. That's.
Well, here's the fucking scary part of what you're saying. You're right. It's not open and shut. What they did was took male frogs, put them in this tank for 3 months, and they turned into females. Same water.
Yeah.
Same water.
You're drinking.
Everybody's drinking in America. That's what the water they used. And just by coincidence.
Everybody's gay and
our
trans.
Epidemic right now is what? Trans. Everybody wants to cut their dick off and become a woman in sports and all that. And this is new, right? We didn't have this problem 15 years ago.
Yeah.
The same thing that turning the frogs gay.
Yeah.
Turns out, not that far-fetched.
The only people that had, like, trans part of their culture were the Thai people, the lady boys.
Yeah, but that was sex and money.
Yeah, but they've been doing it a long time.
But that was strictly money.
Yeah.
These people are confused. Like, I'm a girl. I'm going to chop my... You're mutilating fucking children, right? Because...
Yeah, it's fucked up. It's extremely fucked up.
And goes back to the simple point, you're turning the frogs gay.
Yeah, and it ended up, Musk and all these people are like, oh, actually, he's right. Now, he simplified it gay.
Yeah.
But it just meant the whole gamut, trans, feminine, the whole gamut of, like, no longer male.
As
strong,
you and I have
male.
Been making jokes for many years, and every one of them jokes about Alex always turns out true.
Yeah. Well, the one he said, you know, everything from the Hadron Collider to the to what we're talking about now. The AI is going to get smart. They got to stop it now. He was saying, don't do the AI. It needs to not be a thing. It's going to kill us all. He was talking about that in the 90s.
Yeah.
And he was right.
Which is funny. He was wrong about one thing, and it ruined him. Sandy Hook.
The Sandy Hook thing.
They had one opening, and they destroyed him with it.
Yeah, well,
not even interdimensional aliens.
I don't want my life ruined, but there are some really weird things about Sandy Hook, but I'll never talk about them.
I have no idea what you're talking about,
but I don't want. I don't want my fucking life ruined. Yeah.
I disagree with you at a fundamental level.
Yeah.
You can't say that. You can't. Now you're getting chat. You're getting chat bot. Yeah. You're done. You're done.
They sued Remington, first of all.
Yeah.
The fucking the firearms manufacturer. Like, give me a.
You're going to go home and your fridge ain't going to work.
Yeah, I'm going to shut up. I don't want my life fucking ruined over this shit. Okay. They tore the school down. No investigation. Come on, people.
You ain't got to say school. All you got to say is, like, he was wrong about one thing, and it was the end of him.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, actually, it wasn't the end of him. He's still out there crazy as ever. He just ain't got no money.
He got no platform. They deplatformed him.
Yeah, but he's like, the funny thing is, Twitter, like, the thing about Musk, people hate on him, but he kind of, like he won't let Alex Jones ever back on there, but Alex Jones' wife is on there, and she posts videos of him talking, and Musk isn't taking that down. He's like, so Alex Jones is on Twitter. He's like, but he's just on his wife's account. That's
like, I love Elon. Like, Elon's like me with a ton of money. Like, I'm gonna make a fucking spaceship and find out if there's aliens.
You know, Musk is like, no, you can't come back on Twitter. You're on your account, okay? Your account. So just call your wife and go on her account and say whatever you want. Hey, what's up?
Welcome, Crystal.
Yeah, we're crazy. We know. We're well aware of it.
She's laughing at us.
The eugenics plot. See? She's chat. She was sent.
I believe it.
She was sent by the AI.
What are you
AI.
Pointing at? I don't know what that is. You went to Mega Millions?
The AI chatbot center. So, yeah. So, we talk about how it's all tied in, our whole life. The aliens.
Alex Jones was right about the frogs being gay. I'm just can't get over that.
Yeah. I know. At the end of the day, his number one meme that he's made fun of forever ended up being true.
Now, do we agree that this was before the transgender women in sport, sport?
It was long, long before that.
Yeah. Everybody goes, I mean, the memes were great, too, though. Frogs are gay. Yeah, yeah, I love the fucking memes.
Yeah. I love the baby-flavored Pepsi. That's my favorite one.
God. That slipped my brain. I love it.
Yeah. I ain't drinking. He goes, I'm not going to drink Pepsi with baby flavor.
Baby flavor Pepsi.
Yeah, that's so great. Have you ever had a baby flavored Pepsi?
Interdimensional demons coming here. Yeah. Huh? Alex Jones.
Well,
for those of you who don't have a visual right now, Crystal is staring at us going, what the fuck are you guys talking about? Interdimensional demons and frogs are gay.
Baby flavored demons.
And if you don't know what that means, it probably sounds a little silly. Like, maybe it sounds a little off.
It's all true, though.
But it's true. But it's true.
I find
except
it.
For baby flavored Pepsi and Sandy Hook. That's not true.
Yeah.
Interdimensional demons?
It's 100%.
Frogs are gay? That's not completely true. They were just transvestites.
The other
playing in male frog sports.
But he was right about the chat the AI chat bots getting too powerful. And but the one thing that hasn't happened, he's afraid that the Hadron Collider is going to rip a wormhole and like a mini black hole and kill us all.
Yeah, that was the scariest thing about the Hadron Collider. Was,
yeah,
I mean that.
Well, they were moving particles around and weird shit was happening.
Yeah. So and they were talking about making mini mini tiny black holes, and they fucking said that they were making mini black holes. They put out that statement. Fair enough. The whole world went, "What? Stop doing
what
that."
What if we get sucked in?
Yeah. It also, to be fair. Not a single human being on this entire fucking planet understands how a black hole works. None of us do. We're still going on 1908 theory of what Einstein said.
Well, and based on what...
Alien.
Because they're ripping those little mini black holes. Really, all it seems to do is move stuff around.
At a very horrible rate, though.
Yeah.
But they
created time travel with it. With the particles, I don't know how it works. I'm not smart enough to know.
No, we assume that's what we don't even. Nobody on this planet knows
there
how black
no time.
Works. But there was, what, 2005, where the entire planet was like, oh, my God, a black hole is going to happen. To be fair, the scientists didn't know if that was real either. They were just trying stuff, hoping it worked.
Yeah, black holes are real.
Did you see the new scientific thing that came out? It's the first time in history. I mean, this is like 3 weeks old. They say they seen inside a black hole now. I think it's the James Webb Telescope. I don't know what the fuck they did, but they said they know they seen for the first time in history inside a black hole.
I did. Her name was Shanae.
I skipped the article because girls were shaking their butts on TikTok. Yeah, but
they did.
Seemed kind of important, but who cares?
Yeah. That's a top content on there. Like you look at some random girl will be twerking, millions of views, but some guy trying to save you from black holes killing us all will have like 1,900, like barely any views at all. I'm trying to save you.
Listen
to me.
Don't upset me.
We're all gonna die.
I have been yelling for years, Graham. Like I just discovered, human history is 5,000 years older. Nobody cares.
No, they don't care.
Nobody cares.
They'll even believe you. Like, oh, really? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But did you see this girl twerking? Yeah.
The gravity of what that statement is hasn't sunk in at all. And I mean, like I said, I've been using "to be fair" for a second now, so I'll use it again. Doesn't really matter.
No.
I just happen to enjoy this shit. But what if I were to tell you? You know what? We discovered civilizations 15,000 years older.
Yeah.
So. Changes nothing.
Yeah.
My favorite.
Oh, but my internet's down. Okay.
My favorite thing in the whole universe that I love to death. If you were to, everything that I have said about it, if it were all to come true and be fact, doesn't matter.
Recorded in the pits of Detroit, Michigan.